church. It's Tuesday morning and time for us to get into the Word of God. And we're going to move into the story of Esau and Jacob for just a little bit. We saw Isaac's birth. We saw Isaac's marriage. And Isaac's going to have some children. In Genesis chapter number 25, we're told that Abraham, after Sarah's death, remarries. And that lady by the name of Keturah was able by Abraham to have 6 sons. And so now Abraham has 8 boys. He's got the 6 sons of Keturah. Their names are mentioned in chapter number 25, verse 2. And then also he's got Ishmael, who has already been sent off with some blessing and with some things that possessions that Abraham has given to him. But Isaac is the one in whom Abraham says, it's through you that God is going to bless and bring forth a nation. And so Isaac is the blessed son, the begotten son, and God is going to use him. Now, here's the mystery. The Arabs go back and say, no, it was not Isaac whom Abraham had chosen or whom God had chosen. It was Ishmael. No, it wasn't. It was not any of the sons of Keturah. It was not the son of Hagar, but it was the son of Sarah that God has chosen. And so many of the things in the Middle East today could be settled by that. But it even goes even beyond that generation to this generation that I'm going to be talking about. Isaac has taken a bride, Rebekah, and after about 20 years, she finally is able to conceive, and they bear twins. And God tells her that there's going to be 2 great nations come out of these boys. She's having some things going on inside her. She recognizes there's some struggle, some strife. She's not sure. She prays about it. And God tells her in chapter 25, verse 23, that there are 2 nations in your womb. 2 people shall be separated from your body. 1 people shall be stronger than the other. The older shall serve the younger. And so God tells her, you've got 2 great nations in you. But listen, the oldest is going to serve the youngest. In other words, even while in the womb, God chose Jacob over Esau. Now, God loved them both. God loves all little children. But God knew what Jacob would become, and God knew how Esau would reject the birthright and despise it. God knew these things before he ever created them. When he reached into Rebekah's womb and was creating them and making them, he knew exactly what they would do, every word they would say. And God, not based necessarily on merit at all, God chose Jacob because he knew that Jacob would keep the covenant of God. And so these 2 nations are going to come forth. And so Isaac and Rebekah have these twins, and they're going to both be nations, and they do become great nations. But Esau is born first. Now he's going to serve the younger. So we have Edom, the nation of Edom, and also called the people of Mount Seir. And then we have Israel. Jacob's name will later be called Israel. And so Israel and Esau have a contentious relationship. Beginning in verse number 29, it talks about in chapter 25 that Jacob cooked a stew. Esau came in. His name was also called Edom. And that he wants some of that stew. And Jacob says, well, I'll give you some of the stew if you'll sell me your birthright. And Esau says, what's it to me? I don't care. I'm about to starve to death. All he was concerned with were the temporal things. And so Esau sold his birthright. And the Bible says in that last verse, 34, thus Esau despised his birthright. And so, yes, it was divinely appointed by God, but also it was a choice made. Now, we have to keep those things in balance. God is in charge of all things, and he's sovereign. He projected this was going to happen. He knew it was going to happen. Did he cause it to happen? Well, you can debate that all day. We just know that Esau was the one, it says, despised the birthright. He chose to give it up. And therefore, it's now Jacob, the nation Israel. And so the land, the covenant, the blessings, the inheritance, all those things are given to Jacob's people, Israel. And so that land in the Middle East was given for forever. It was made a covenant that land belongs to Israel and to Israel's people. Let's pray together. Father, we thank you that we can trust in your plans and that you have a plan for us, even while we were in our mother's wombs. You created us and you fashioned us. You know who we are, and you've called us unto yourself that we might walk in faith with you. Use us for your glory and for your honor. In Jesus' name, amen.